Hey guys, this is the Hunter with Hawkeye, and it's going to be the inaugural Let's Play video in our series. And today I'm excited to announce that we're hunting in a brand new reserve. We are in Val-des-Bois. It's just been released a couple hours ago. And we want to get after the new species, the alpine ibex. This reserve does have red fox, red deer, roe deer, brown bear, and the alpine ibex. So, looking at my equipment, I'm bringing a 9.32. Again, I haven't retired this rifle yet. I'm going to bring a Parker Python. I struggled with that decision, but I'm going to bring it along in case we want to take something down silently. And I've got the roe call, I've got the call for the red stag, I've got the jackrabbit call for red fox, and I've got the new climbing gear. Now, this is about, I used GMs to purchase mine and got this 20 pack for I believe it was 1,200 GMs, so not bad. And today I'm bringing along a tent. This is the first time on the reserve. We're going to get up into some higher elevation. And what I hope to do is get up there and find a good home base that that we can spawn at next time. I started at 6 a.m. I wanted to see what this reserve looked like during sunrise. And wanted to give us some extra time to get up here and get climbing. So I've never been here before. I'm gonna start up this trail, and I'll pause the video and bring it back when we get some action. I wanted to bring you guys on quick and show you what the sunrise looks like when it hits that mountain up there. That looks like what Half Dome looks like when it gets hit with the light in the morning. It's just amazing. We've got a first track here. And it's a roe deer. It's fairly fresh. I'm going to track him down. Get eaten by a bear if I'm not careful. Let's go ahead and take him. He's a big bear. Check in on that roe deer. Well, I threw a flyer at him. That first shot looked good to me, but he didn't drop. I don't think I hit him with my desperation shot. That roe deer's on the heavy side. I wouldn't mind tracking him down. And, you know, I'd rather get into some ibex. Let's see what we've hit here. Lungs, okay. It's not all bad news, is it? So, this is an alpine reserve, kind of modeled after the French Alps. And it uses the summer sneaky 3D camo as the quote-unquote proper camo. I'm wearing the Doc camo today. I'm hunting like a proper gentleman this morning. I've got a thermos of coffee here ready to go. 22.8. We'll hold off on the trophy shot on that guy. And I'm going to keep following this trail and hopefully find a place that I can deploy some climbing equipment. We want to get up that peak there, get into some Ibex. Okay, so we got our first rock slide, and so the Ibex don't actually make a sound themselves. What you get on the hunter mate is an indication that they have knocked some rocks down the mountain, and you're hearing these rocks slide down the mountain. So we just heard that up here. I'm going to pick up these tracks along the way to see if there's anything close, but we're going to get where we can spot the side of this cliff, and hopefully there'll be an Ibex there that we can shoot. I just spooked this roe deer a second ago. It was right on top of me. This might be kind of tricky to spot through all of these pine trees. Thing I like about these rangefinder binoculars is I can hit a spot on there. I can left click and I can go back and look at the map and see where that is. So it is higher up than the spot that I just placed. So we'll try again. I was in line with it. Maybe somewhere in that neighborhood, I think. Where he's going to be. I don't know how skittish they are if I'm not going to be able to see him through these pine trees. I'm going to have to come right up here to the bottom of the cliff. Does rain instead of snow here. There's one. Wow, he's up there. Yep, he didn't come here to stare at him. Okay, we'll let you shoot up at that angle while I'm running down anymore. And he went over the edge there. Alright, so I'm going to stay put for a minute and hopefully find something. Alright, I'm assuming that that Ibex went over the other side of the mountain. So what I'm going to do is go down here where the trail meets the mountain. I'm going to assume there's a way that you can climb up from there, and if there is, I'll show you that. I'll show you the new ropes and how all that works, if I can hopefully do that without falling down and injuring myself. Okay, so I heard that Ibex again and then heard another one. So they're up here. And here is the first climbing location that I have found. That's all there is to that. So you put that, I had it in equipment slot 8. And I just hit 8, hit the left mouse button, and here it is. And we're going to try and climb up without falling. Try, I said. Wow, that thing does not move as much as you would like for it to. Literally holding the button down to go the other way. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Well, you learn something new every day. That has forced me to go back to the lodge and start over. Well, at least we can get a shot at a male roebuck here. Should be just across the river. Which has a nice little golden sunrise glow to it. A small one. Out and got a bigger one to come in. Not big, but bigger. Alright, I'm going to stop the video and I'm going to sprint back to our climbing gear and hopefully make it up the mountain here. Check that out. Nice rainbow. A decent view here already. That's a double rainbow. Okay, here we go in for our second attempt. Just before I approached this, I heard another rock slide. Not too far from here, on the top of the mountain. Hope we can get up here and not spook anything and hopefully get a shot at an Ibex. Wow, this is crazy difficult. Okay, so I'm here, and I'm hearing something close. So what did I do different that time? Well, when the arrow was moving off to a side the first time, I would stop and try to correct it. That's not what you want to do. You want to keep going up, keep hitting that W button the whole time. And just tap it on the directions, the A and D keys, and that should get you righted. If you sit there and try and sit in the same spot, I think it gets harder and harder. And I don't know what that sound is that I'm hearing. I assume that that's going to be some Ibex, so I will seek those out and come back when we find something. There we go. It doesn't look very big, female, but we're not going to be picky on our first one. They make a habit of disappearing right before I shoot, aren't they? Okay, so here's a trick with the rangefinder binoculars. She was standing right in there when I shot her. So I'm going to left click. And it'll put the red dot on her, that location on the map. So if I get distracted, I can always go right back to that and start my blood trail. Alright, so we're at the blood trail. Doesn't look like it. Oh wow, it's right here, okay. I didn't see her fall. And I don't know much about their scoring, but I know that's not too good. First one, we're gonna get a trophy shot anyway. Thank you. is coming. We got lucky on that one. We're sitting there taking a trophy shot, and this Ibex comes running up. I guess she wanted to get in the picture. Same size. All right, you can see our rope that I put down. It leaves an icon on your map, which is pretty cool. It stays there forever. Like any heavy equipment, it'll stay there. I'm gonna assume that there's a climbing spot right there, so I'm gonna head up that way and hopefully climb up another level, and I'll bring you in when we get some action. Okay, here we are approaching the next climb spot. So as I thought, right here on this little dip is a nice stack of rocks we're going to try and climb. Wow, I was on by one hand there for a second. So, I guess I'm now officially an expert climber. Take a look at the scenery from up here. Check that out. Check those mountains out on the other side over there. I'm assuming that would be these down here, so I'm not sure that the reserve allows you to hunt those, but you can hunt the base of them, and it's like about halfway up. So we are here. We've climbed two spots. There were ibex sign all over between those two spots, so we're gonna hunt this a little bit, and if we find another way up, we're gonna hit that. Otherwise, I'm gonna keep an eye on these mountains and an ear open for ibex. I wanted to show you guys this this countryside here. This is just amazing. Look at that big valley there. You got all this small brush and rocks. And over on this side, you've got this big stand of pines. Surrounded by mountains on all directions. It's just amazing. I'm gonna get up on higher ground where I can look down on things a little bit better. So we are hearing all kinds of things. Looks like down in those pines, from an ibex. Again, I'm going to use my rangefinder binoculars, and I'm going to say probably right around in there. Check it on the map, he's actually a little closer than that. So we go back to that spot, and we're going to bring it forward a little. It's going to be right in there, right there. It's a female, and she is moving fast. She's got places to go, huh? Let's go collect her. So you can see by the solid halos that this was the one that was making a mess. Actually a male, small male. 122. Alright. So I'm gonna go back to exploring up here. Alright, what I'm going to do now is head up here where I can get a view of this cliff face and the one on the other side. Hopefully we can spot some ibex scaling the rocks up there. That's the goal. Also, I want to remind you guys on whenever there's a new species released, like there has been today, when you find a track, you're going to want to, even if you have to backtrack, you're going to want to collect all three tracks to get your skill up as quickly as possible, get it up to a respectable level, which is what I've been doing here, especially after I just fire a shot at the rifle. I might sprint around for a minute or two because I've already spooked everything, and I'll sprint around and collect all the tracks I see. And sure enough, we have heard one up there. Gonna use my trick with the binoculars, but I'm not sure that I'll be able to see it. So that's pretty close to where we heard the noise. Looks like there's a little pocket right in here. But there we go. There we go. Now, I don't know much about ibex, but that one doesn't look too bad. 240 meters. Four of them up there. I'm actually gonna make my way a little closer and try not to spook them. Take a shot, see if I can make one take a tumble off that mountain. So I'm going to take a bit of a gamble here. There's still about 215 meters or so, and I want to be closer than that when I look at them and see which one is the biggest. So I'm actually going to go up. I've never been here before. I'm hoping there's a way I can get up the mountain here. They're making all kinds of noise. I want to get up the mountain over here and look across at them. And if I can see them from there, I should be in a great position. So I'm almost to the top. I wanted to show you guys this valley from up here. Isn't that amazing? We're actually up here above the clouds. You can see the clouds moving through, about to hit those pine trees. Look at that. Sun rays shining down. We got ibex knocking rocks off the mountain above us. Just a amazing reserve, the new Val-des-Bois. So I'm not so sure this gamble's going to pay off. I did just spook an ibex up here. It's not the ones that we were watching. But it looks like as I keep going further and further up, the terrain keeps pushing me further and further northeast, and I need to turn back the other way to spot that cliff. What a beautiful view from here, though. I'm going to check all that out in a minute. I want to look at this spot where I know there's ibex, and then we'll come back to this. Wow, what a great job they did here. Okay, wasn't as bad as I thought. Just rounded the bend up here, and here we can spot this massive cliff face. There's one of the ibex. I don't know where the others went. I might have cost myself by taking too much time to get around. So I keep getting new trails, so there are multiples up there. It's just a matter of me finding them. I'm gonna work my way around the top here and hopefully get some more spotted. Okay, I've been here studying this cliff face for a little bit. Now there's more than one up here. I can only see the one, but I heard another one somewhere. I don't know if it's on the other side of this little lip up here or what, but that group is gone, so as far as I can tell. So I am going to shoot this one. It is a male too. Since rushing it, we'll wait till he stops. There we go, and now we're gonna pray he slides to the bottom. Keep an eye on that cliff. I don't see anything running. We'll go collect him. Alright, so we got another small male, 117. So, there's tracks all over this. I'm sure these are the ones that we saw earlier. So I just hit tracking level 2 for these guys. Be a long road, I think, on that. So I'm gonna track these as we go. I'm gonna go over that lip right there and see what's on the other side. So here is the other side of that. How beautiful is that? You got all this these small shrubs, rocks. You got this massive mountain up here, and then the one that we shot that ibex off of, still prominent on our left. So I'm gonna hang out for here for just a second and make sure I spot every inch of this, because it looks like a really good place for ibex to be hiding. So I'm gonna stay here for a minute, see if I hear some rocks sliding, and I'm gonna spot this valley. Alright, I didn't spot anything down there. That doesn't mean that there's nothing down there, just that I didn't spot it. See, here's that other group from before. They're making some noise. I'm gonna make my way down there. I believe that's the group that had 3 or 4 together. It had a pretty good male with them, so we'll see. So they've actually gone down a level. They should be right down the hill here. This is really close to where we shot that last male. Hopefully I can slip up here and look down without spooking them off. And go ahead and crawl the rest of the way over here. Try to crawl on top of this rock. Should be visible down here somewhere. Howling up here, huh? Where is this guy? There. What happened is he came towards us and was at an angle we couldn't see down to him. Female. 108. Everything I've got today has been right around the same score. So I'm going to cover some ground, head further back here, and pick you guys up when I get some action. I'm in that valley that I was spotting earlier that I was so sure there wasn't anything in, and there is an ibex fairly close that I keep hearing. And I'm tracking one, but I don't know how fresh these tracks are. Fleeing, so it can't be that old. I spooked one, and except he went into that little ravine there, and I cannot see to make a shot. So so I'm going to hang out for a little bit. It's going to move eventually. When it comes out of there, I'll take a shot at it. So I'm crawling my way over here to look down the valley, and I'm hearing a rock slide up here directly ahead of me. I think I see it up there. Yeah, I do, but again, I can't move up. Can't do that while I'm prone. I have to go into crouch to do that. That's actually, that looks bigger than what we've been killing. But I'm still gonna come over here and see if I can get eyes on that one I spooked. He should be down here. There is no telling where that one went. Meters on the other one. He should slide right down. Hopefully slide right down to me. I'm gonna go ahead and take a shot. And I can't move my gun up. That is frustrating. Okay. We'll wait until he stops. Oh, he's outside the reserve. How do you like that? I can't shoot at him. Okay, so back to plan B. We're gonna have to find something else or see if he gets closer. So I've decided to take us away from the border there. There's not much we can do. That other one that we spooked went across the reserve border as well. We've got one down the hill. Here we go. I see them, two of them moving. Three of them. Oh, they're fighting. Wow, that was cool. So that's supposed to be a pretty rare occurrence. I think I'm going to take this one going down the hill. Maybe we'll get lucky and get two. He looks all right. Okay, so he went over the lip of the hill over there. We are going to pursue him too after we collect this guy. Came back over the hill. This actually looks like the small one, probably the female. That other one was definitely bigger. And so I brought the tent. I didn't have a whole lot of room, which means I only have one bullet left. So whenever I take a shot, I'm gonna have to set up a tent, grab some more ammo out of it. looked good to me, but it didn't drop her. So I'll go ahead and mark that spot, and I'll head down here and get this guy. We'll set up a tent and grab some ammo, and might leave the tent over here depending on what this looks like. Alright, here we are at the first one. This was the ram that was fighting the other. He looks better than what we've been getting. 174. It's alright, still CSS 38.9. Which means he's not a big trophy or anything. About 90 kilograms. But as you can see, they did a very good job on these models. Just amazing. Alright, we'll go collect the other one. Alright, we are at the blood trail. Tracking's not good enough to tell me what kind of blood, but it's not too terribly dark. And I'm not sure where she ran from here. Also, keep in mind that other ram is going to be... Oh, hey, there she is. That other ram is going to be around here somewhere. Which is why I'm not walking. Wow, look at this view. So we're at the boundary edge over here too. So we'll pull up the map and show you where we're at. We started here, we went up here and climbed, broke a leg, healed up, went back and climbed again, climbed up here. We went around here, came through here, and now we're coming around the back side. So I want to check out this other side up here while we're on top. As far as locations to put my tent, right now what impresses me most is that valley down here. Which is probably where I'll put it to leave as a home base. That way I could start a hunt up here and not have to worry about climbing. I could just spawn in at the tent and go to work. So I'm going to see if I can find this other ram. Okay, so that got a little hairy on the other side over here. Too much pine tree, less open space, getting into brown bear, red fox, that sort of thing. And started going downhill pretty quick. And I didn't want to do that right now. I wanted to come back around here, get my tent set up for future hunts. And we just heard one of the ibex from earlier, because he had three red dots, which means I've had him fully tracked. But we just heard a rock slide from him. It may be that one that was outside the reserve earlier. So I'm gonna see if I can get a shot at him before we call it quits here. So as we were slipping up the hill, he was coming down the hill, and now he's right down there where we can't see him. He's right down under that little lip right there somewhere. So I'm gonna crawl over here and look over the edge of it. Yeah, he's moving quick. I need to get over here where I can see over that stuff. Got myself in a bad position. I think we can crouch over here without spooking him. Hold the count on that. Start crawling here. Okay, should be visible anytime now. Listen for rock slides or anything that might indicate where he's at. There we go. That's that. Okay, good, we got two down. So this one's not very big at all. It's got little tiny horns here. 59, that's our smallest one of the day. We'll get the other one. Here we go, another small one. 107. Back to our future tent location. Alright guys, this is the Hunter with Hawkeye, and I believe we're done hunting for this let's play, and I've got my tent set up. I'll show you on the map in a second where I've decided to put it. Of course, it's always subject to change, but this has just been released today. The Val-des-Bois reserve for the Hunter with a new species, the Alpine Ibex. So what did we learn today? Well, when it comes to the reserve, we learned that it's beautiful and it's also dangerous. You can fall down some of these cliff faces and you can hurt yourself. You need to pack a first aid kit with you or be sent back to the reserve when you do hurt yourself. There's also brown bear, adding to that dangerous element. You have a new climbing rope system. The system is, it can be difficult. You guys saw me bust it on the first attempt, and then we eventually got it down. But the trick, I think, is to hold that W key and tap the A and D as you go up. If you start to lose it and let go of that W key, I think it just makes matters worse for you. So the other things we learned, even though this is this reserve is modeled after the French Alps, it does use the summer sneaky 3D camo as the quote unquote preferred camo for the reserve. It does work here, and it also rains. It doesn't snow here, it rains instead. But everything about the reserve appears to be very well done. And you can hear up here where I'm standing. You can just hear the wind howling. You can hear the hawks. You can hear the rock slides when the ibex scale these mountains, which is all very, very cool and adds to the immersion of your hunt. So about the ibex, what did we learn about ibex? Well, you can't call them. There's no such thing as a caller for ibex. So it's strictly spot and stalk and keeping your ears open for those rock slides. They also are not afraid to go outside the reserve boundary. We saw that a couple of times where I spooked them and they went up outside the boundary where we could clearly see them, but we couldn't shoot them. The other thing is they'll occasionally butt heads, and we got some pretty cool footage of that in this hunt, where we got to see actual two rams actually butting heads, and we were able to take one of them. We think the bigger one. I'm not sure. We never did see the other one again, as he went over the edge of the hill. Other than that, pretty good hunt. I will link the hunt details in the description here. And again, this is The Hunter with Hawkeye, and thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you enjoyed the video, or leave feedback if you didn't. Leave feedback anyway. Let me know what you think, what you want to see next time, and we'll keep them rolling. Thanks for watching.